Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 High Grade Gundam Ariel. Yeah, I finally got to her, and I like how she looks. Some people say the proportions are a little weird, the limbs should be longer. I think they're fine. And you do have some stickers. You could use ones for the eyes and the back camera, but they have the green plastic, so I figured, no, why bother? You got one underneath the forehead here, on the backpack, you got these ones on the shoulders. You can use the ones on the chest, but they also have the pre-tampered ones, so I'll use those instead. And you got ones in the thighs. And I believe that's everything. And, articulation? You got the double ball-jointed neck. You got the arms that are ball-jointed, and they can move forward some. Arms go out. Rotate below the shoulder. One joint at the elbow. Ball-jointed wrist. You have a hinge in the torso. And then you got these side skirts that can move. I find they pop off some though. Front skirts here a little, they can move. The legs can go not that far forward. Farther back. They can go not that far out either. And some thigh rotation. So kind of hindered in the thighs. Nice double jointed knee. And then you have the hinge in the foot. And the ankle armor is ball jointed at the front. And the feet can tilt, but they're separate from the heels. Which I'm not a big fan of. They should be able to just gear those in together with little, like, little tabs on the ends of the, like, the peg that goes in, but whatever. So, not as articulate as I thought it'd be, at least in the lower half. The top half's pretty good. Now, comes with the beam sabers on the back, and you do get a pair of clear blue beams. And these aren't even the right ones. There should be flat ones. Oh, here they are. I think those are left over from the, real grade... high noon. There you got the flat ones, which go right into the hands, no problem. And you've got the beam rifle, which definitely looks better than the Lfrith because of the, it doesn't have like a huge gap in the front. It looks more like a gun. I got the sticker there for the sensor. And you can put it on the back, but you just have to use this adapter piece. And then you can peg it on the back. Probably on the back skirt too. Yep. So you can do that if you want. And I usually just leave it on, because it's not, like, super in the way, so I just leave that in there. And it is a nice tight fit in the hand. And like the Lfrith, you can take the beam effect and shove it in the barrel. So it has a big beam saber if it needs it. And then, of course, we have the shield, which I really love the shield. Like, this thing looks great. Very nice. And once again, you can peg on this on the back if you want, and I suppose you can peg it on the butt. And of course, on the arm. But I'm sure a lot of people feel the way I do. The fact that you have to have this gray piece to connect all the gun bits, that's really bad considering the Lfrith did it without anything. And I never thought the shield would have been able to work the way it does on the Lfrith. And they didn't do it here. So let's separate everything. I think this comes up first. It's kind of tight. Yeah, it pegs in here. These are stickers, unfortunately. And you got these ones. And... oh yeah, the stickers are already coming off this one, of course. These are all plastic, surprisingly enough. That, and then little teeny gray ones here, and they have little flip-out tabs. That's what I thought they'd have for everything, just little tabs at least that flip out. They did it there, they just didn't do it anywhere else. And now to put everything on the aerial, we'll just come back with this piece, and take it in there. And you do have to put these back on, but I just want to show you that they are separate, and they do fly around and fire their own little beams. But... if you get that stand, because there isn't a stand add-on kit you can get, so you can have all of these gun bits displayed separately, but I'm not going to bother wasting my money for that. If I had the space, I probably would, but I don't, so I'm not going to do it. You got this thing, which goes over here, and then you got the one where the sticker's peeling off, goes over here. It looks like a little shield, kind of. That one just looks weird. And then you got these ones which peg into the shoulders. Like, does the yellow go up or down? I can't remember. I think it goes down. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm sure it matters, but I don't care. Yeah, there's the aerial with all the gun bits on it. This is kind of cool. It looks like a little flight unit. I think they open up when it flies. So, that is the aerial. It is, I think, a pretty good model. I'm not a fan of this thing that's left on, but I guess if you want to just put it on the back, you know, out of sight, out of mind sort of thing, it's not terrible. I still think I like the Lfrith better, but this is a good kit. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.